Hey everybody, I want to wisdom here. It is Sunday, August 18th, 2013. We were here last night. I did, for the record, actually get the round five matches in our Castaways versus Castaways, Newlanders versus Newlanders up on the blog. In addition to that, I uploaded about 15 videos. The plan over the next little bit of time, hopefully, is to upload one or two videos a day. It'll primarily be the Series 2 Skylander upgrade paths. So be looking for that. There will be a link back to the blog where I'll keep them all archived for you. One of the reasons I didn't actually record this late last night, knew my nephew would be over today, and that is the case. Last recording I made here, it was actually the unboxing of some Shogun Steel Beyblades. I actually edited that last night. It'll be coming up soon. My nephew was the one that hid Chase McCain in that video. It was really hard to find him. I think somebody might be able to find him if they're really looking for him. Alright, but as I was saying, this time around he's a little easier to find. My nephew did hide him this time. I think you'll be able to spot him. That said, right before coming up here, we played, was it Deluxe Edition?
Of what?
Battleship.
Yeah,
it's Deluxe Edition Battleship. It's the one that actually talks, you program in the coordinates. We were down. We played as a team. We were down 3-0. Looked like we were basically just done for. And we made a rally. We actually sunk 5 in a row. Of course, the last one we found was a little tugboat. So pretty happy about that. That said, this time around, left the polls open roughly 2 weeks again due to, you know, schedule and time constraints primarily. We tended to have... Every battle had at least 60 votes. The most, ironically, was Jetvac and Pop Fizz, which was also a landslide, but it clocked in at 67. That said, we're going to go ahead and cut to the chase. You know the drill by this point in time. If you're new to the series for some reason, basically what this is, it's stage 2 of our Castaways versus Newlanders. You can take that blog link at the top of the video description. Basically, it'll recap the series, show you how everyone's accumulated the record they have. And then eventually, once this stage 2 is done, we're actually going to pair them off in a tournament bracket, see who comes out on top of the Castaways head-to-head with the Newlanders. Our first matchup on the Castaways...
Actually, what we were planning to do in the tournament is we were going to have a Castaways bracket and a Newlanders bracket... And then, depending on what happens, we might actually have, in the semifinals even, have the Castaways battle the Newlanders and the Castaways battle the Newlanders. But I don't know, that might be saved for just the finals, so we're guaranteed that... A Castaway and the Newlander battle in the finals. I don't know. We'll just see how it is.
All right, but anyway, what we had was Warnado. He came in as our 5th-ranked Castaway. Record of 5-3, 1-2. And then he's going up against the 8th-ranked Castaway. Voodoo comes in 3-5, 0-3 against his fellow Castaways. The way this one came out, 38-22. That's a +16 margin of victory. The winner, Warnado. As I was saying just a second ago, you know, we want you not to just consider battle mode. We want you to consider voice acting. We want you to consider the upgrades, how well you like them in the game, the aesthetics of the pose. You should know the drill by now. Like I said, go back, visit the blog. In terms of what I would select in this one, hands down for me, it would be Warnado. And now, what'll make this video special, we're actually going to get another opinion from my nephew here. So, Warnado, Voodoo, what is your take?
Well, now Voodoo, I would say he could beat, like, Shroomoo and Whamshell, but I think Warnado would have won that hands down.
All right. That brings us to... Our next matchup, this one, I think I mentioned I wasn't quite sure what to expect from it. Dino Rang came in 5-3, did really good against the Newlanders. However, he has a bit of an issue here, 0-3 against his fellow Castaways. Which again is to be expected, as you know, great as so many of these characters are. Boomer came in 5-3, performed very well against the Newlanders, 1-2 against the fellow castaways. This was a 6 Boomer versus 7 Dino ranks. So you should expect them to be fairly close.
And keep in mind that I think in the first round of his Series 1 Skylander Battle Tournament that isn't on his blog anymore, but I remember that in one of those Round 1 matches, I think these two battled, and Boomer came out on top.
Yeah, this time around, though, this was the closest battle that we had. Had a couple of close ones.
One vote victory for, you have the honors,
Dino Ring. I tell people every time, you know, you might see something that's a blowout and not bother to vote. You might have a tough time picking, but if you are a Dino Ring or a Boomer fan and you're kind of on the fence, kind of seems like an odd pairing if they were your two favorites. I guess it could happen. But I always tell people, remember to err on the side of caution. Try to pick a favorite, you know, unless these are your two favorites, that's understandable. But try to weigh it in, because, I mean, 2-3 people do that, and it's a different outcome. That said, 31-30, Dino Ring took down the Clobber Troll, Demolition Troll, Boomer. This is a tough one for me. I could see, I mean, if you want to talk PvP, I could take either one of them down with the other one down either path. It's kind of be a good match. I mean, you got projectiles on both ends. You can go a different route, kind of more, close range brawler, if you will. In game, Boomer is absolutely hilarious. Dino Ring still remains one of my personal favorites. Of course, he's from the Earth element with me, but also unique. I mean, the boomerang's unique. When you get the sticky boomerangs, you can pick up the items. Just a lot to like about him. I will let my nephew go first on this one. Which one would you pick?
I would probably go with Dino Ring, just because I'm not that much of a Boomer fan.
Yeah, and I would actually, as much as I hate to, I would have to agree with him. Boomer, still at this point, I'd still label him underrated. He started to become more appreciated, but just in terms of all the neglect he had in SSA, it was not due to people upgrading him to the max and playing him. It was just probably an aesthetic thing. But I would give the edge to Dino Ring again. He's just personally one of my favorites. So consensus, you the fans, myself, and my nephew all give the edge to Dino Ring. That, of course, will bump Dino Ring to 1-3 against the Castaways, and Boomer falls to 1-4.
And this time we have a very interesting match. It is actually Ghost Roaster and, oh, I don't know who that other one is, Sunburn.
Yeah. All right, so this one, it's essentially a number 2 versus a number 4. I mentioned last time how great these matchups were. I was kind of torn on between Camo Whamshell and this one, which I thought would be closer. The way this one panned out, what was the total vote count? 63 total votes, and this one was close. I monitor these, you know, throughout all the blog, or time they're live on the poll.
Like, he doesn't go, okay, now that the vlogs are up, I'll just do whatever I want, and I don't have to look at them.
Yeah, we usually, me and my nephew usually check them a couple times a week, if not daily. That said, this one was a +3 margin of victory. Again, it's one of those things. I actually do know of a couple of people that these are their two favorite characters, so again, it is understandable, you know, if in that position, but as it panned out, and this is why I always tell people, tell your friends, make sure to vote. If you're a big Sunburn fan and it's a close match, you got to rally. Same with Ghost Roaster. As it is, 33-30, go ahead and tell them who came out on top.
Maybe Ghost Roaster?
That is correct. Ghost Roaster barely, and I do mean barely, edged out Sunburn, 33-30.
3-vote margin of victory.
Now, myself personally, I think I'd have to give it to Ghost Roaster. Again, I'm a big fan of Skullmaster. He was one of my first, I mean, I got him launch day of SSA, you know, Toys R Us was giving away Darklight Crypt. which is insanely hard to find now, at least in the U.S. But he's done everything I could want him to do. Tons of fun in the game, totally unique.
He's even stood up to two of some of our strongest Skylanders, Slambam and Terrafin.
Yeah. Sunburn, you know, I could see him taking Ghost Roaster in PvP. It still slightly does bother me. Sunburn can't fly, even if it was just to hover. The teleportation is pretty cool, I'll give him that. That said, I mean, again, just factoring in everything, gameplay, player versus player, aesthetics, I'd give it to Ghost Roaster. What was your take on this one?
Definitely Ghost Roaster.
All right, so again, 3-0 consensus for us here.
I mean, definitely, like, in general, like, how much I like him. Bam, I like Ghost Roaster more, and in player versus player, unless Ghost Roaster was controlled by a really bad player, I couldn't see Sunburn having that good a chance of winning.
All right, so that of course is going to drop Sunburn 6-2, 2-2, and then Ghost Roaster improves to 7-1, and pay attention to this one, 4-0, undefeated against his Castaway crewmates. That's important because in round 5, we're going to have the showdown. Anyway, the camera basically just dismounted from the tripod and turned itself off. Seems to be working well, but what I was saying is pay attention to Ghost Roaster's 4-0 mark against his fellow castaways. We've got the Showdown of the Millennium coming up in round 5. Definitely want to check back for that. That said, that matchup brings us to our final Castaway Showdown. We have Camo. He comes in perfect 8-0 against the Newlanders. Perfect 3-0 against his fellow castaways. However,
wait,
as our number one,
did he win the tiebreaker against Pop Fizz, right?
I believe so.
Because wasn't he the one who tied with Pop Fizz?
Something like that. Anyway, Whamshell comes in. He was our number 3. Pretty respectable mark, 7-1 and 2-1. This one again, for me, it wasn't necessarily marquee, but based on what I thought we would have with voters, I could see this one being really close. I would have to come in here, and I'll tell you straight up, the vote total on this one was 38-24. That's a plus 14 margin of victory, 62 overall.
And the winner was...
Go ahead and tell.
Camo!
That is right. Camo took him down by 14 votes. I kind of thought he would still win. That said, I do realize there's like a really big Whamshell faction out there.
I don't know what it is about him, but... I mean... Sure, I guess his weapon is pretty awesome, but...
Yeah, and basically that's what my nephew said. It's kind of my thoughts on it. You know, I don't hate Whamshell, I enjoy him, it's just he's had so much hype around him since the beginning, in part because of how insanely hard it was and remains to find him. I feel like that kind of pushes him up. And in my opinion, in-game, Camo, pose, Camo, player versus player, Camo. Easy decision for me. My nephew agrees. Again, we have a 3-0 outcome there for you. But this will drop Camo to 7-1 and 2-2, a 500 mark against his fellow castaways. Camo improves to 8-0, of course, against the Newlanders, and then 4-0 against his fellow castaways. You heard me mention it last time. Ghost Roaster is also a 4-0. Epic Showdown coming in round 5. Let's see here. I will just back Camo up right there, really annoyingly close to Ghost Roaster. Not saying that'll be the matchup or anything in round 5, just a little something we're doing. That said, we're going to go ahead now and go into the Newlander break. All right, our next matchup comes in the Newlanders round 4-1. It is Jetvac, hailing from the air element, going up against Pop Fizz, magic element Newlander. Jetvac comes in 1-7, 0-3, not doing well at all, and that's probably not a good sign. You can see Pop Fizz pouring the potion out. Pop Fizz 5-3 against the Castaways, which is a very good mark, and 3-0 undefeated against his fellow Newlanders. You probably know how this one turned out. Pop Fizz garnered, this one actually had the most votes, which was weird to me. I know Pop Fizz is insanely popular, but I would have thought like Sunburn Dino Ray, I mean Sunburn Ghost Roaster, Camo Wham Shell, even Hot Dog Fright Rider, I thought would have had more votes, given how close plus one it was. Dino Ring Boomer, thought maybe that would rally, but this had the most votes, and it was also the biggest blowout. You probably know which way it went. Pop Fizz, 50 votes. Jetvac, 17. That's a plus 33 margin of victory.
And Pop Fizz won?
Yep. What is your take on this one? Who would you pick out of these two?
Well, I haven't, you know, have much... I don't have much experience with either one of them, but Pose, Jetvac.
Yeah. I would actually agree. This is a decent pose on Pop Fizz, but comparing it to Jetvac, I felt like that was a really, really good pose. Kind of your flagship Newlander still. Me personally, this is a tough one. Pop voice acting, hands down, Pop Fizz. That said, you know, that's just one of the small things factored in. Pose, I'd give Jetvac. Pop Fizz is a ton of fun. I feel like I could actually beat, which I can do that with pretty much anyone. There's just some that are like blowouts, you know. But player versus player, I feel like I could take either one down with the other. I'm going against the grain big time here, but I think I'd go Jetvac. And that was my nephew's consensus too, I know, because he voted in the blog. So anyway, we went against the grain here. Again, big win for Pop Fizz. He's our biggest blowout. He's taken that honor home a few times. Probably will again as he continues here through the Newlanders. But just Jetvac, he's kind of, I mean, I don't want to say he's like Boomer, but I mean, I kind of feel like out of all the Newlanders, he kind of gets a raw end of the stick more often than not. That said, 2-1 there, my nephew and I taking Jetvac, the masses going with Pop Fizz. So the 17 people, I guess 16 since my nephew voted, that went with Jetvac, we're right there with you. Our next matchup, the female showdown. We have Earth Element Newlander Flashwing. She flies in. She's up against Tech Guru Sprocket. Their marks were, let's see, 1-7 for Flashwing, 2-1 against the Newlanders. I told y'all, a lot of these bottom dwellers, Chill, Sprocket, Shroom Boom, Flashwing, Jetvac, didn't do well at all against the Castaways. Against their fellow Newlanders, that's going to change. Some of them are going to make runs turn out to have respectable marks. Sprocket, 1-7 overall against the Castaways, 0-3 winless against your fellow Newlanders. This one turned out to have a plus 28 margin of victory, our second highest, just 5 shy of the biggest blowout. The way y'all voted, 45-17, and the winner, Flashwing, just too much for Sprocket. Yeah. What is your take on this one?
I'm thinking maybe, like, I mean, definitely Pose, Flashwing. Never heard either one of their voices, so I can't say that. I'm pretty sure Flashwing would do better in the game. And finally, player versus player. Yes, I know Sprocket would dominate. Not!
Yeah, so... that's kind of my take in a nutshell. Flashwing, insanely powerful. Of course, for myself, you should know by now, I'm a big Earth Element fan. That did not stop with the original SSA cast. Flashwing, very, very impressive and powerful down either path. Sprocket, again, not a horrible character. I think she is someone that you have to spend some time playing with down the upgrade path to really get full benefit. But me personally, I'm going to go with the masses and my nephew. I'm taking Flashwing hands down. All right, our next one. I thought this one could be interesting. Like I've said all along, you've kind of got three characters at the top on the Newlander side. Pop Fizz, Hot Dog, and then Fright Rider. Fright Rider is in an interesting spot. He performs pretty well against the Castaways, which you have to admit are eight of the toughest battles you could have. But he doesn't have a great mark. But that said, he's not down there at the bottom with everyone else. So he's kind of like our middle ground and third place contestant. That said, Hot Dog, 6-2, very, very great mark against the Castaways.
One more thing. I'm thinking, you know how all the underrated guys, and I told this to one of Wisdom too, but I think since all the underrated guys like Chill and Lashwing are up against easy opponents, I'm thinking their popularity will grow, so they'll have a better chance against the tougher opponents.
Yeah.
Like Dino Ring and Voodoo. But I'm still sure that Wernado or some of the super strong fighters would still slaughter them, but still.
2-1 was Hot Dog's mark currently against his fellow Newlanders, I'm sorry. Of course, Pop Fizz took him down not long ago. Fright Rider comes in again, fairly interesting. He is 3-5 and 3-0, so he's done great against his fellow Newlanders as well. That said, the way this one panned out, only had 60 votes, which again was kind of odd for me, you know, given how relatively close these two are. I mean, I feel like if you're a Hot Dog fan, you probably don't like Fright Rider much, and I feel like if you're a Fright Rider fan, you're probably not a big Hot Dog. It's kind of like polar opposites here. I realize it's not elementally opposite, but in terms of like gameplay and aesthetic, you know, you kind of got like the cute fire pooch, you know, that's appealing to the masses, and you've got like Fright Rider, kind of the intimidating. I would have to say, out of the Newlanders, I don't think anyone would argue if you wanted to pick the most intimidating, it would be Fright Rider. Would you agree with that? Just based on the other seven characters?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, so you kind of get where I'm coming from there. You kind of got like, oh, cute, it's a little fire puppy. And then it's like, oh, wow, he kind of looks scary, you know?
But I guess I would not want to be hit in the face with that thing that Chill's holding either.
That said, you know, that kind of made for the dichotomy here. The way this one panned out, it was a +8, so it actually was pretty close. Again, just a couple more people, you know, could have gone either way. That said, Hot Dog took the win.
What?
+8. You heard my nephew's reaction. I'm guessing you would pick Fright Rider?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm
like
going to...
all spots.
Yeah. Again, I realize Hot Dog, Pop Fizz are insanely popular, yada yada. I like them. I mean, don't get me wrong. That said, the pose, now, if you know, they do the Series 2 Hot Dog, that one actually looks like a really good pose with the bone. That aside, Fright Rider's pose, completely unique. Again, I'm all about the unique elements. He's riding an ostrich. You know, I realize that's Fright and he's Rider, but still, that's like the first time we have a Skylander mounted on something at this point. Plus, on top of that, he's holding a spear. His upgrade paths, both unique. Granted, one of them has my name in it, which is awesome. But they kind of do require a little skill and practice. In-game, you know, it is fun to play with Hot Dog sometimes. That said, I do personally enjoy Fright Rider a bit more. Bottom line, I'd go with my nephew, go slightly against the grain here and take Hot Dog. Our final battle here comes down. Life Element Newlander. What's his name?
Shroomboo.
Correct. Versus Water Element Newlander.
Chill.
Who also has a... blue and gold.
Mm-hmm.
Is what?
It is Light Core Chill.
And...
legendary.
Correct.
Chill.
So, as you can see, my nephew is basically a walking encyclopedia of all things Skylanders, too. That said.
And if this was Pokemon, like, I would see Shroomboom being a grass type and Chill being an ice type. And so Chill would probably get the 1 or 2 move win if this was a Pokemon game.
Yeah, he is a Pokemon connoisseur. But anyway, Shroomboom, 1-7, 1-2 against his fellow Newlanders. Chill comes in 0-8 and 1-2. This was essentially, I forgot to give you the rankings here. Shroom Boom was what, I think, 5th, and Chill was 6th, essentially. This one had a total of 62 votes. It was a plus 12 overall. The way this one panned out, 37-25, and Chill iced down the Life Element Newlander Shroom Boom. What is your take on this showdown?
Definitely Chill, hands down.
Okay, so didn't take him much, you know, time or reasoning it out there. I would have to agree. While I do, again, Shroom Boom, I'm anticipating Jetvac and Shroom Boom kind of, you know, being close there with Sprocket. But does play great. Again, to me, there is that issue, you know, with his secondary path. I was expecting to be like Zooks. I think over time, he's going to wind up, you know, probably around this time when the next game's coming out. I think people will be like, hey, Shroom Boom's pretty good, you know. Should have picked him up when I had the chance. But as is, Chill. I realize her light core leaves a lot to be desired, you know, but don't hold that against her. You know, this is taking everything into account. Chill offers up unique gameplay, and again, you've heard me say that like 3 times now in this video. It is akin to Slam Bam, but what I continue to say is I like how she can throw through the wall. Kind of adds a new and unique element to it. Again, Shroom Boom, you know, nothing against him, but just me personally, I've got to take Chill, pretty much like my nephew said, every way, shape, and form. So that kind of wraps this up. This was round 4 of Stage 2 in our Castaways versus Newlanders, which, of course, at this time has evolved into Castaways, Castaways, Newlanders, Newlanders.
And the next battles will be Crusher versus Ninjini and Drevac. And T-Rex versus Flashwing.
Yeah. So, I was just joking there, by the way. But round 5, you're definitely going to want to check that out. I've got it pinned out here. Again, it's actually on the blog. You can already vote in it. I've only posted it on Twitter. You know, I didn't take the time to throw it up on Facebook or Google Plus or YouTube yet. But that way, you know, when you go in, there will be a few votes. We checked. There were 4. We were surprised by the, I mean, there's not a lot of, you know, resultage to be surprised by, but we had some surprises when we checked. That said, I will just leave it at this. If you're just getting into this or seeing this for the first time, for whatever reason it may be, go back, take that blog link at the top, familiarize yourself with kind of how we've gotten to this point, but more importantly, check out Round 5. It's on the blog, oneofwisdom.com. It's on the right-hand side, just below the Twitter feed. You'll see I've got a couple other big-time polls as well. Which Swap 4 starter pack are you going to get? Your favorite dark, you know, starter edition character. And then similarly, do you prefer Giants or SSA? But right below those, you're going to see the polls that are actually going to be these battles. It'll begin with Warnado. And our last one next time will actually end Shroom Boom and Fright Rider. So you've got 8, basically, battles you can vote in. And I will just say this. There are going to be some killer showdowns, one of which could be one of the best battles we've had. And we've had some good ones. I mean, we had plus 1 here, plus 3. That said, I mean, record-wise, matchup-wise, this is gonna, it's even elementally opposite. It's going to be awesome. I alluded to it earlier, one of the big showdowns, and I say one because there are more. It's going to be Camo and Ghost Roaster going at it. You definitely want to get your vote in on that. Camo, currently our number 1 overall and Castaway, he has got a mark of basically 12-0 right now overall. Ghost Roaster on the flip side, 2nd-ranked Castaway, 2nd-ranked Newlander, 11-1. You get the idea, this is going to be big. Camo's either going to distance himself or Ghost Roaster's going to tie him up and take the overall lead due to the tie break. You have something you want to say?
Yes.
Okay.
These 2 Skylanders...
Move that arm, there you go.
Their battle, I actually think this has been the closest battle just for me. Like, if I was having to reason this one out,
yeah, my nephew is a big Voodoo fan, so.
And I think one of Wisdom is two, but
yeah,
not near good enough to think he could beat Ornego. So, but anyway, for me, like, there weren't many tough matchups out there for me to decide. For other people, I know it's probably different, but for me, the closest battle is probably between these two. Just in this round, not in the entire series. But I do still go with the... What did you say? The...
Ornado?
No, go with the...
Popular? Masses?
The yeah, votes? Whatever that was.
Yeah, he went with what y'all voted for, basically. In terms of my toughest ones this time around, maybe Boomer Dino Ring. Jetvac Pop Fizz was tough for me, too, just because Pop Fizz is a lot of fun to play as. But biggest blowout basically went kind of like I thought it would there with Sprocket. But again, like I said, on the Newlander side, while we're going to have killer matchups in the Castaways, we're going to have some good matches here just because, like I said, we had four characters down dwelling at the bottom. They're going to start to distance themselves. You're sort of seeing that. Chills clicked off two wins in a row. Flash Wings heating up. I think they just kind of pair up better because, like I've said, you have to admit, if you're going to pick eight Skylanders out of a grouping, you'd be hard-pressed to find a better eight than the Castaways. Keeping them kind of separated like that, at least. But again, this was round four. Big thanks to everybody who voted.
And then again, in the next one, I might actually have to do some thinking and not be able to say, hey, this was my favorite matchup.
Yeah. Which, speaking of that, I'll get that video up right after this one. But you definitely want to check it out. Head to the blog, cast your votes. Again, oneofwisdom.com. Polls are found on the right-hand side just below the Twitter feed. Questions, comments you can ask here on YouTube. For a quicker response, I suggest you use the blog. Feel free, come in here.
But post. Do not ask where Chase McCain is, because we will not tell you that. We might give you a hint for last video.
Yeah. If anyone's having trouble finding Chase from the last video, let me know. We'll try to help you out. That said...
But we will not say, hey, he was right here.
Right. That said, big thanks to everybody who's voted. Be sure to spread the word. Tell your friends. I know a lot of you are back in school now. This is basically like the last week of summer. So as you get back into school, maybe, you know, like say you're a huge Sprocket fan and you're miffed that she's like lost all these battles. Tell your friends about this. Get them involved. See if you can't maybe rally for your favorite characters. And again, I'll tell you right now, there are going to be some incredible matches next time around, particularly Camo Ghost Roaster. But you can follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, circle me on Google+, whichever you prefer. Be sure to check out...
Or if you want to do all three.
Yeah, that's true. Like my nephew said, do all three and subscribe. Go for the trifecta. But be sure to check out my nephew's blog, which is...
TheWalkThroughKing.blogspot.com.
And his YouTube channel, which is...
TheWalkThroughKing.
That's right. He's, of course, my first featured channel. I've had a lot of people ask me, like, hey, who's that? And that's my nephew. So kind of answers that question for you. But, again, big thanks to everybody who's voted. The polls are currently already up. I got them up last night. Again, I waited to do this because I knew my nephew, you know, would be over here.
And One of Wisdom is also my top featured channel.
Yeah, kind of works out good that way.
However, you can go to my channel and you'll meet some pretty cool channels. Other than his, you'll find Sugar Connery, Octane Blue, Mario 54321. I just have a lot of... I don't just go see one and then say, hey, I'm gonna feature this channel. I don't put featured channels on my channel that much as when I started. However, I do have some pretty neat featured channels that you might want to look at. Some for if you want to see cool Mario 64 movies. Some for if you want to if you're having trouble with your games, you know the drill.
Yeah. So like he said, be sure to check that out again. You have a favorite out of those? Is that too difficult to decide?
Well, I might actually have to go with one of Wisdom, but out of everyone else, you might have to give me a certain topic.
Okay. Like
walkthroughs, either Sugar Connery or Octane Bloom, might have to go with Sugar Connery just because he does a little more stuff in one video, but it's still pretty hard for me to decide.
Yeah. And Octane, you've been watching him for how long now?
Pretty long, maybe.
Yeah.
At least 2 years. But same goes for Sugar Connery. I come across his playthroughs or walkthroughs a lot, too.
Yep. But, main thing is, great matchups gets coming around. Be sure to check them out. But what we want you to do, of course, here, come in, tell us, you know, hey, I'm so glad that, you know, Dino Ring edged him out. I voted for him. You can say, man, I can't believe Boomer lost. Basically, come in, tell us who you would have liked to have seen, what you agree with, what you disagree with. If you're one of the 17 people that picked Jetvac, come in, tell us why you picked him. Just kind of like I say, this always makes stuff more interesting for all of us. It's kind of another outlet for Skylanders. But as I was saying, this is basically just another outlet for all of us to enjoy our Skylanders. Again, big thanks for watching. Big thanks for voting. Make sure to subscribe. Be sure to check out my nephew's channel. Round 5, again, up on the blog. You have any last thing you want to say in about 10 seconds?
Thanks for watching.
Yeah, there you go. That's all we've got. Again, we sincerely appreciate it. We will catch you back for the Round 5 matches.